let's get underway. Straight to our Olympic heroes.
And our Olympic favourite, Valerie Adams' bid for a gold medal was not to be at the London Olympics on Tuesday, but silver is awesome. We're joined now by Te Karere's Irina Smith and Valerie. Mālo ilale, Valerie and Irina.
Mālo ilale, marama. Well, Valerie, so much hard work, but the Belarusian was so strong. How did you feel out there?
Feeling out there, I tried my best, you know, I left my heart out there trying to win golf for New Zealand and try to defend my title, but it just didn't work out. It was her day and she threw better, and I'm in great shape and I can't blame it on that. It was just a matter of I didn't have a valves competition, you know, and but I still should be happy, and I am happy, and I'm sure that the happiness will become bigger as the days go on, but I'm really disappointed.
Did you expect her to be that strong?
You know, in the last couple of months, she's throwing really well, like just in the last couple of months in Belarus, and I wasn't quite sure whether, you know, it was that she was going to be throwing that far, but I knew there was potential to, and I know I had the potential, but it just didn't come together last night.
Still, you got New Zealand's first silver medal. You're not that far off at all.
Yeah, I suppose in your eyes and probably everybody out there, but in my eyes I think it's different. You know, I've worked so hard, and it's been a very, very long journey this year. I've been away from home for so long, and my coach has been absolutely fantastic, but it's very disappointing.
I mean, how do you cope with the years of pressure and preparation? I guess, would you have done anything differently?
No, I wouldn't have. You know, what we've done is the best we could have done. It's sport, I suppose, and it's life, and we just have to roll with the punches now. Yeah.
Reports from back home are saying that everyone's behind you and so proud of your efforts here at the Games. How does that make you feel?
You know, I'm very humbled by that and very happy that people support me, and very... you know, it's great knowing that people do support me at home, whether I've won or not. That's always great to have that sort of support behind you. Although, as an athlete, you always want perfection and you always want to do so well, but I do thank the people of New Zealand and also the Tongan community for their support. Yeah.
So, Val, where to from here for you? Is there any other competitions coming up, or you're thinking about Rio yet?
You know, I just need to finish off the season this year. I'm definitely, you know, obviously thinking of Rio. I haven't made any quite stern decisions yet, but I've got four more Diamond Leagues to go and then a few more competitions when I head back home.
Well, mālo, opito, Valerie, thank you very much for your time today. And back to you in the studio, marama.
Thank you, Irina. Well, you can't help feel her disappointment there, but we are so proud of you, Valerie.
Definitely proud. Now, Valerie's silver at the Olympic Games has made her family and community proud. Valerie's late mother was from the village of Houma in Tonga, and her extended family there were over the moon with her medal.
The village of Houma is a world away from London, but at the family home of Valerie Adams' late mum, there's been loads of Olympic fever. Kasanita is the younger sister of Valerie's mum and says Valerie's mother, Lilika, would have been proud.
Thank you, Valerie, for what you've done. Your daughter's proud and very proud of you, and I know your mum is watching them.
Meanwhile, in South Auckland, at Valerie's old high school, some of the seniors watch a replay of her finals.
I'm very proud, knowing that she was an ex-student of Southern Cross. Even though it's a silver medal, but we're really proud that she actually got out there and did her best.
Tongan students make up a third of the 1,800 strong roll here at Southern Cross campus. None more proud of Valerie than her niece, Leah. The 15-year-old even took up shot put after being inspired by her auntie.
She got me into shot put. She showed me some of her skills. Yeah, I started liking shot put and discus.
And one of the school's special awards is the Valerie Adams Sports Trophy.
We are very, very proud to have this trophy donated by Valerie Adams when she was a student at our school.
Was this really her own shoe?
That is correct. That is her real shoes.
It looks big. What size is it?
Oh, huge. I think it's probably size 13. For a big woman like Valerie, this size 13. And our school is very proud of it. And then I think a lot of our students are inspired.
Mr. Kaufusi says their students will keep following in her footsteps, and Valerie Silver is a win for Mangere.
I think that we are going to go crazy. When she comes here, we're going to be at the airport with our flag, and we're going to sing a song for Valerie. And I think we are, not only as a Tongan, but as a New Zealander, people are very proud of her.